Hi everyone, today let's learn to use the new repeats tool on handweaving.net and also how to transfer drafts between tools without downloading and uploading them first. Let's work with draft number 33123. By default, this draft is shown with 4 repeats, but maybe we want it to have fewer or more. To change the number of repeats, we can now go to Tools, Draft Repeats, and we can choose the number that we want. So let's make it 2 in the warp and 2 in the weft. And so now it's only got 2. And if I download the draft right now, the downloaded WIF will have just 2 repeats in it. So let's make it have more. Let's make it have 8. There it is with 8. And again, if I download it now, it will have 8 repeats in the WIF. So you can use this with any existing draft on handweaving.net, and you can also use it with new drafts that you create with the tools that are shown here. Okay, let's put it back to 4 repeats. And now let's go to the draft editor with this draft to change it. You'll see that there's a new tools button. This is shown on all of the tools pages wherever there's a draft. And the draft that's closest to the tools button can be taken to other tools to work on it. So for this one, there's only one draft, and so there's one tools button, and let's take it to the draft editor. So I click Tools, Draft Editor, and now here we are in the draft editor with that draft ready to work on it. So I can manipulate it here, I can change it. So let's add some warp threads and some weft threads. I'll click Threads, Add Thread, and now I will add 4 warp threads at the end. Same thing here, I'm going to add 4 weft threads at the end. So now, let's fill in those warp and weft threads. So we'll just make them the same as the beginning of the pattern. There. So now the pattern actually has 4.5 repeats in each direction. There's a partial repeat at the end. And typically, those are not desirable because if you repeat the draft, the partial repeat would make a non-matching section at the boundary. So I did this because I want to show that the draft repeats tool can remove partial repeats. So if we go to Tools, Draft Repeats, it will detect that and it will actually remove it. See, it's gone. Now, if you wanted it for some reason, like the draft actually has a partial repeat as part of the pattern, you can still get it back. If you check these boxes, the partial repeat comes back. But by default, it takes it out. So that's it. That's all there is to know about the draft repeats tool and moving drafts in between tools. Thanks for watching, and I hope this video was useful.